fucking income fucking poop.
It's kind of like Jesus. He died on the cross for all our sins. Well, I've been in the penitentiary and been hit in the head, stabbed, shot, slept in cars to amass this knowledge that I have.
Jesus H. Christ. You gotta be shitting me. A jelly donut.
Like, this is the realest shit I ever wrote or said. Wake up with it every day and take it with me to bed. Hurting my heart and hanging over my head. About the realest nigga these Texas streets have ever bred. C.L. Butler, better known as Chad. A Pimp C, the closest homeboy that I ever had. Now when we first met, we wasn't on the same page. Repeated misunderstandings, they got clearer with age. Two young boys who was ready to mash. Put PA on the map and maybe make a little cash. Jump down with Big Time, put down a few songs. Everybody co-signed saying that we could do no wrong. It hit the streets with a big ass bang. Them gangsta ass rhymes with that country ass twang. Drop, tell me something good, took out and went live. Shit, next thing you know, we was signing the jive. Drop too hard to swallow, a pocket full of stones. Put the remix on Menace, shit we had it going on. Got love in the streets and played on the air. But the homie putting us out wasn't playing too fair. I had to separate ourselves, bring in a new team. But sometimes the other side ain't always what it seems. We dropped Super Tight, an album full of killer flows. But then we got caught up with the drugs and the hoes. We didn't realize what was happening on the real. The new management was cutting backroom deals, hiding different money and concealing the price. He had us doing all the work but was keeping the biggest slice. Took a while to catch on to what homie was doing. But by the time we did, all the paperwork was in ruins. Nigga kept all the receipts so we couldn't file taxes. The next thing you know, IRS hitting us with axes. Pimp, you owe 7 figures, but you owe 6. Better get your paper together, get this shit fixed. We nixed the management team and tried it ourselves. Cussed out the GM, almost got put on the shelf. Fuck it, drop riding dirty, it's the classic in the South. Reclaim the Southern title, shut everybody's mouth. Got some clout in the game, boys calling us the greatest. But meanwhile, me and Pimp is still ducking haters. The old manager calling and say he finna sue and put a padlock on everything we trying to do. Put a call out to the prince. This nigga still hating. We got heat for the street and we can't keep the people waiting. He made a call or two to some folks telling the man, you gotta cut UGK some slack. Understand, young Pimp got the plan, Bun got the drive, Rap a Lot had our back and we just waiting on Jive. We got the big bosses on the same page, so me and young Pimp could hit them from center stage. Next thing you know, we got this call from the NY. It's Jay-Z saying, y'all niggas been fly. He doing volume 3 and got a track from Tim, and wonder cause some trio niggas rocking with him. Shit, Big Bun was all for it, but Pimp wasn't sure. But Big Pimpin' hit a 187 viewer. Number one song on every station you turn on. MTV and BET, we getting our burn on. Grammy nominated, can't believe that we made it. Then we got a call from Jive that left us all faded. And it stated that due to the success of the track, we here at Jive Records would like to piggyback. Get another beat from Tim, then get a verse from Jay. Let Hype shoot the video and we'll be on the way. Shit, it sounded okay, but me, I had to ask, if we don't do Big Pimpin' 2, will you still put us on blast? A song like that might take a nigga to the top, but my true fan base might think a nigga flop. They got mad and put niggas on hold for damn near a year until the buzz got cold. So we said fuck them and went back to the basics, trying to find ways to get the fuck up out the matrix. We put Dirty Money together and it was aces. But that's around the time that Pimp called 2 cases. He got probation, said fuck you hoes. We finished the album, got ready to do a couple shows. And then he violated 1 month before we dropped. And shit just got put on hold, a fucking stop. out. Now 30 days done, we back to the nitty gritty. Album got released, big show down in Chocolate City. Niggas with masks on, vests and all black. It's Christmas 2001, bitch, we was all that. Strongest on the block, nobody could budge. And then he violated, now we right back before the judge. They calling him a nuisance, put my dog behind the fence. It was January 28th, he ain't been home since. Threw a nigga through a loop and caught me in the cross instead of co-CEO. Now I'm the fucking boss, had the devil on my back. Got the drinking and drugging, had to make a choice. Get back to rapping or thugging. So I walked up to my bedroom, got down on my knees, put my hands together and I prayed, Lord, please let me get past this bridge over water that's troubled and get back up on my grind on the double. He said, son, don't worry, cause it's not really as hard as it seems, and I can turn your nightmares back into dreams. You just gotta stay true to yourself and to see, then push away from the devil and get closer to me. And ever since that night, man, I promise I've been on it, giving the killer flow to anybody who want it. Pimp the pin like never before, I'm breaking them G, not to mention I got the world screaming free Pimp C. So soon as you make parole and they open the doors, you ain't gotta worry about nothing, the world is yours. Ain't no more struggles, my nigga, and no more strife. I kept it real because to me it's UGK for life. We'll be right back.